The Emergency Response Guidebook, known as the ERG 2016, provides information for first responders during the critical initial phase of a dangerous goods or hazardous material incident. This tutorial is based on the How to Use This Guidebook flowchart, located on page 1 of the current print version of the ERG. Let's get started with an overview of the iOS version. Imagine that you arrive at the scene of a hazardous material incident. When you first assess the situation, you want to look for an explosive placard or label at the scene. Next, open the ERG 2016 app. If you see an explosive placard or label at the incident, touch Browse Guide Pages. Then, touch Guide 112 for Explosive Divisions 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, or 1.5, or Guide 114 for Explosive Divisions 1.4 or 1.6. If you do not see an explosive placard or label at the accident scene, you'll want to search by the substance's name or UN number. Or you can search by image. If you know the substance's name or UN number, touch Search by Name or UN to find the guide or protective action distance associated with the substance. For example, chlorine will direct you to Guide 124, gases, toxic and or corrosive, oxidizing. This guide page provides potential hazards, public safety, and emergency response information. Unlike the paper version of the ERG, the app couples all the necessary information for each material so that you can find it all in one place. If protective distance information is available, touch the protective distance icon. You will see initial isolation and protective distances for small spills and large spills. This information differs depending on the substance. Some substances, like chlorine dioxide hydrate, include instructions for handling the substance if it spills in water. Others, like this one, include additional large spill sections that include instructions based on the types of spills. Finally, to establish a protective distance, touch the map button. Enter the spill location and wind direction, as well as any other details that you have available to see a map of the protective distance that you should establish. Some pages include special instructions. For example, if the guide number has a P next to it, the guidebook page includes fire and explosion instructions. These materials may suffer violent polymerization. How you triage depends on the incident and information available, and just like the earlier examples, some of the explosive substances do not include initial isolation zones. Acrolein dimer does not include initial isolation zones. Acrolein stabilized does, as noted by the green outline around the guide number. If a guide page does not include initial isolation and protective distance information, use the orange page for guidance. If a material, like acrolein stabilized, includes initial isolation and protective distance information, first, determine if the substance is on fire. If it is not, go directly to the initial isolation and protective distance information. If the substance is on fire, use the orange page first to locate evacuation information in the public safety section before determining the initial isolation zone. If the material causes additional dangers when it mixes with water, like sodium hydrosulfite, the protective distance section will list generated gases. Now we'll talk about searching by image. From the home screen, touch Search by Image to identify placards and rail cars or road trailer images. Look for placards first. If no placards are visible, touch to view rail car or road trailer images as a last resort. If you see an image that matches the one at your accident site, touch it. The associated guidebook page will open. If you don't know the name or ID number of a material, you can search by image. However, the images section should only be used as a last resort if the hazardous material cannot be identified by shipping documents, numbered placards, or orange panel number. A few last reminders. For mixed loads or unidentified cargo, refer to Guide 111. Also, touch the Reference Material button to see important information found in the white pages of the physical copy of the guidebook, such as the BLEVE table and a glossary of terms. This concludes the ERG 2016 for iOS overview. The U.S. Department of Transportation's Pipeline and Hazardous Materials Safety Administration developed the ERG 2016's free mobile app in partnership with the National Library of Medicine. The mobile ERG will make it easier for the nation's emergency first responders to quickly locate the information they need to manage hazardous material transportation incidents.